Miss Fox was the smartest, most beautiful creature in the forest. All the animals were in love with her, and every one of them wanted to be her beau. So Miss Fox decided to throw a dance so she could meet them all, hoping that she could find one that was as smart and clever as she was. She invited only the strongest, smartest, most handsome animals, oh, the bobcat, the coyote, the wolf, the bear, and especially the most powerful of them all, Mr. Cougar. Now, it wouldn't be a party unless she had music, so Miss Fox asked Rabbit to play for her dance.
Mr. Rabbit, I've heard you're the most wonderful banjo player. Would you play for my dance?
Now, Mr. Rabbit was deeply in love with Miss Fox, too, but Miss Fox didn't know it. Rabbit asked her,
Well, who's gonna be there?
Oh, all the smart, powerful animals. Bobcat, coyote, wolf, bear, and of course, Mr. Cougar.
Mr. Cougar? Why, he's my riding horse.
You silly. Mr. Cougar could eat you in one bite.
Well, maybe that's so, but I ride him wherever I go. I'll probably ride him to your party.
Ride Mr. Cougar? That's impossible. I'll believe that when I see it.
Well, Miss Fox, I'd be delighted to play for your party, but, you know, I'm awful forgetful. Maybe you better send Mr. Cougar by to remind me.
So Saturday night came around, and Miss Fox made sure Cougar stopped by Rabbit's house to remind him about the dance. Rabbit was sitting on the front porch, plunking on his banjo, when Cougar arrived. But Rabbit didn't look so good. He had bandages all around his head. His leg was in a splint. Even his little cotton tail was in a tiny little sling.
Hey, short stuff. Time to go to the party. Or have you already forgotten?
Oh, no. I'd like to go with you, Cougar, but I feel terrible. My head hurts, my arm's sore, I can't walk, my foot's broken, and even my tail is dragging. Just leave me here. You go on ahead.
Now, wait just a minute. This party is for my girl. You promised to play music for it. If there's no music, there's no party. You promised, and you're gonna play.
I want to play. I want to go, but I can't walk. My head hurts, my foot's sore, and even my tail is dragging. But maybe I could make it. If I was carried.
Carried? Well, I guess I could carry you there.
Oh, what a great idea.
Well.
How would you do that?
Well, you could just get up on my back.
So Rabbit picked up his banjo and hopped onto Cougar's back. But as soon as he got on, he fell off.
Ouch! Cougar, you mind if I put a blanket on your back?
Oh, do what you must, but let's get going.
Rabbit threw a blanket on Cougar's back and hopped up again. But he slid off.
Oh, ouch! Mind if I add a saddle to keep the blanket on?
Do what you must, but let's get going.
So Rabbit strapped on the saddle. He hopped on the Cougar's back, and again they started off, but Rabbit fell off again with a big commotion and the banjo crashed to the ground. Ouch!
This is about to kill me. You know, Cougar, this'll never do. I need a bridle and reins or something to hold on to. I can't hold on to nothing.
Do what you must, but let's get going.
So Rabbit got a bridle and reins. He crammed the bit into Cougar's mouth. He picked up his banjo and a little switch and hopped onto Cougar's back. And they started off. Rabbit began switching Cougar around the ears with one hand and playing the banjo with the other.
Hey, short stuff, what you doing?
Oh, I'm just swatting flies off of you.
Then Rabbit started swatting him on his tail end.
Ouch! Ooh, ouch! What in the world are you doing now?
Well, we need to go faster. My head is about to bust.
As they rode along, Rabbit took off the splint from his leg and threw it behind him. Then he took the bandage from his head and the sling from his tail and threw them away, too. Then he combed his hair. He perked up his ears. He fluffed up his tail. Ooh, he looked as regal as a prince. When they finally rode up to the party, everybody was standing out in front, waiting for the dance to begin. They all saw Rabbit.
sitting on a saddle on the back of Cougar, holding the reins and riding him like he was a horse. Rabbit hopped off of Cougar and tied the reins tight to a tree. "Evening, Miss Fox. Are all you folks ready to dance?" No one said a word. They just stood there, their jaws hanging open. Rabbit hopped inside and hollered, "Grab your partners and circle up four." Everyone was so shocked they followed right along behind him. Cougar was left tied up tight to the tree. Rabbit started to play. "Oh, grab your partner, don't be slow. Swing your corner and away you go. Right hand cross the howdy do, left hand back and a fine thank you." They danced long sets and they danced squares. They danced till they were completely worn out. When the party was finally over, Miss Fox stood at the door and said goodnight to her guests. After everyone was gone, Rabbit started to leave, but Miss Fox stopped him in the doorway and said,
"Rabbit, that was the best music I ever heard, honey. I can't remember when I had so much fun. Now, I don't know how you rode Cougar here, but however you did it, you must be mighty smart. Anybody that can ride Cougar and play banjo is good enough for me. I've been looking for somebody as smart as I am, and I think I've found him."
Cougar overheard this and let out an angry growl. Miss Fox ran out and saw that he was still tied tight to the tree.
"Were you still here, Cougar, honey? Goodness sakes, the party was so much fun, I plumb forgot all about you."
"Untie me. I've never been so humiliated in my entire life. You tell that rabbit I'll be waiting for him. When I hear that banjo, I'll know right where he is, and I'll come and I'll swallow him down my goozle pipe."
Then Cougar turned around and slunk off into the darkness. Well, Rabbit and Miss Fox got married, and they lived a long, happy life. But Rabbit never forgot Cougar's threat. He put the banjo under the bed and never touched it again. Of course, that was a long time ago. But that's why, to this very day, you never see a rabbit playing banjo.